Hey, I gotta go. Okay, bye.
I'm sorry about that. I'm Ashley. And have you ever heard of a habit? It's a routine behavior that we tend to do a lot. It's something on repeat in our lives. Some habits are great, like waking up early, or exercising, or texting our best friend a funny meme every morning. But other habits can be not as good for us, like chewing gum in class, biting our nails, or slamming the door when we leave the house. And when we do these things enough, they just become part of our everyday routine. One habit we might not always think about is listening. Not just hearing stuff, but taking it in and actually noticing it. We're all over the place when it comes to how good at listening we are. I asked some of my friends on a scale from 1 to 10, how good of a listener they think they are. Take a look at what they said.
What'd you say?
I agree with some of those numbers. I think personally, I'm a good 6.5. What about you? Maybe you're a 10 when it comes to listening. When people talk to you, you pay attention, you focus, and you really try to take in what they're saying. Some of us are more of a 5. As a 5, you listen when you have to listen, right? To your teachers giving assignments, to your parents asking you what you want for dinner, or to your friends when you're hanging out. But as soon as it's something you aren't interested in, like your coach screaming on the sidelines, or your siblings talking about their crush, or your parents asking you to do your chores, well then you zone right out. Or maybe you're honest enough to say that you're just a 1 or a 2 on the listening scale. You tune out a majority of the time. In fact, you might be tuned out right now. So why all this talk about listening? Well, because it's important for our relationships. See, we all know how it feels to be listened to. We like it when people pay attention to us, or don't interrupt us when we're talking, or focus on what we're saying. And we get frustrated when they ignore us, or get distracted on their phones while we're talking, or simply don't even care about what we have to say. When it comes down to it, listening is important in our relationships. The more we do it, and the more others do it for us, the better our communication and relationships will be. The more we'll be connected. The same is true when it comes to our relationship with God. The more you try to listen to His voice, the more connected you'll be to Him, and the more your relationship will grow. When you make listening to God a habit in your life, you'll grow closer to Him and find yourself getting to know Him in a whole new way. Your faith will turn into an everyday faith. If you're anything like me, this probably has you thinking something like, listening to God? What does that even mean? I can't hear Him. I can't see Him. I can't text Him and get a response. How in the world am I supposed to listen to someone who isn't actually talking to me? That's a good point. And while God is fully capable of speaking to us in a big, loud voice, that's not really His style all the time. But that's why He gave us plenty of other tools we can use to hear His voice and listen to what He has to say. Sometimes God uses things like music to encourage or speak to us. Sometimes He uses encouragement from other people to speak to us. But there's one place we can always go to hear God's voice, and that's the Bible. Now, before we go any further, let's just all admit something together. The Bible can be hard to read and even harder to understand sometimes. We go to it for help or answers or to find God's wisdom or guidance on something. But sometimes we walk away with more questions than we even started with. For instance, like, why does the Bible use weird words I don't even understand? Is everything in the Bible real? How do I know that what I'm reading is actually from God? How do I know which parts God wants to use to help me? How do I apply any of this old wisdom to my real life today? I read the Bible, but I don't feel closer to God when I do. That's a ton of questions. And like I said, I've asked them too. It almost feels like trying to connect with God through our reading the Bible creates more confusion than clarity. And if you're anything like me, that confusion can leave you so frustrated. Because maybe you've tried to read the Bible. You've heard it's important, so you give it a shot. But then you got overwhelmed, so you closed it, feeling like not much changed in your life at all. All that stuff about God speaking to you through the Bible, well, it didn't feel like it happened for you. I think we've all probably struggled with something like that before. We read the Bible, but we don't feel any different. Our sadness, our anger, our frustration, or disappointment doesn't go away. The things that made us turn to the Bible for help remain the same. We just don't find what we're looking for. we don't feel closer to God. So what do we do? I think most of us just stop trying. We don't feel like we hear or experience God the way we're supposed to in the Bible, so we move on. We look for other ways to listen to Him. We find new ways to connect. Maybe we even give up on trying to connect with Him at all. But remember, listening makes relationships better. If you stop listening to your best friend, you eventually stop being best friends. If you stop listening to your coach, you don't know which plays to run on the field. And if you stop listening to God, you break a really, really important connection with Him. So what do we do? If the Bible is the best place to find and listen to God's voice, what can we do to keep going, keep reading, keep making listening an everyday habit in our relationship with Him? To help us out, let's listen to some wisdom, you guessed it, from the Bible. It's a few verses from a book called Psalms. This one's pretty cool because it was written more like poetry or song lyrics. Some were written because the author was really, really sad. Some were written to express thankfulness. And others were written to provide wisdom. The psalm we're gonna look at today was written to inspire people to try to live the kind of lives that God calls us to live. And it gives us some thoughts on how we can do that. So let's take a look. Blessed is the one who does not walk in step with the wicked, or stand in the way that sinners take, or sit in the company of mockers. Okay, well, that's a lot to jump right into. Basically, the writer was saying that there are a lot of things and people we can listen to in this world, a lot of voices we can turn to, and the people who get it right, well, they're the ones who choose not to listen to the people making bad choices, the people who aren't following God's way. The psalm calls these people the wicked, the sinners, and the mockers of the world. Sounds pretty basic, right? Just don't listen to those people and we're all good. Well, that's only part of it. Because if we're gonna choose not to listen to the voices threatening to lead us away from God, we have to make a choice to start listening to God. So let's keep reading. But whose delight is in the law of the Lord, and who meditates on His law day and night? That person is like a tree planted by streams of water, which yields its fruit in season, and whose leaf does not wither. Whatever they do prospers. When the writer talked about delighting and meditating on the law, he was simply talking about the scripture. He was saying, hey, if you want to find the best way to live, then go to the scripture. Read it, think about it, study it, pay attention to it. Listen to God speak to you there. Because the more you do, the better your relationship will be. I love the picture of trees and water that this writer used to talk about this. Have you ever seen photos of an oasis in a desert? Kind of like this. Isn't this amazing? Don't you just want to go here? Don't you just want to live here? Look at that waterfall. Like in the middle of nowhere, in the dry, hot desert where nothing grows, there's water. And around the water, tons of trees and plants that flourish. No matter how bad the weather conditions are in the desert, the oasis provides water that's needed for the trees and plants to thrive. Listening to God, it helps us become like the oasis. When we feel the craziness of life around us, we can stay rooted to God. When we feel like we're struggling through difficult seasons, we can survive. When we aren't sure what to do or what will happen, we can find peace in knowing that God is leading us. And when we keep on listening and connecting, we keep growing. We get to know God in new ways. See, listening to God helps us know Him better. And knowing God better changes us from the inside out. Like how the trees are in the desert oasis, they get their life from the water. Our life comes from God. And listening to God makes us and our relationship with Him strong. It helps us have an everyday kind of faith. Listening to God helps us know Him better. And like we said, a huge part of listening to God is turning to His Word. It's reading the Bible. And when we make reading the Bible a habit, it helps us stay strong and grow in our relationship with God. So the question now is this, how do we do it? Well, here are a few ways you can start this week. First, start with your group. Remember, God also uses other people to encourage and speak to us. So why not jump into listening to His voice in the Bible with those who can help you? Groups are places where you can process and ask questions and grow together. And a part of that is learning new habits together. So as you plan to find more of God in the Bible this week, start in your group. Commit to reading together. You can even find weekly devotionals to go with this series on the YouVersion Bible app. That might be an awesome place to start reading together. Try reading. Put your plan to read the Bible into action by actually doing it this week. If your group chose to read a certain book of the Bible together, make time to read it. If you opted for the devotionals, set aside time to read those. Whatever your plan is, make an effort to spend just a few minutes every day actually reading God's Word this week. Lastly, think about it. This is where the reading goes next level. Instead of just reading your Bible and walking away, take time to think about what you read. Ask God to help you understand what He might be saying to you through it. Be ready to listen. And as you do, write down any thoughts or questions you have. Talk about those things with your group the next time you meet. The more you read, the more you'll begin to listen. The more you listen, the more you'll learn about God. And the more you learn, the more you'll grow into a person who is close to and connected with God. A person who has an everyday kind of faith. Remember, listening to God helps us know Him better. The more you make listening to God an everyday habit in your life, the more you'll find yourself connected to Him.